The Ministry of Secondary Education has developed a distance learning platform for students of secondary education in Cameroon. A series of lessons taught by qualified teachers for secondary school students. Under the stewardship of Professor Pauline Nalovalyonga in collaboration with the Ministry of Posts and Telecommunications, CAMTEL, CRTV, and UNESCO, we are introducing distance learning as another teaching and learning method which is different from the traditional classroom setting that you are all used to. In the distance education mode, you are not with the teacher in person, so take your time, relax, listen to the teacher, take down notes and visit the following links for any questions or answers to your questions. Take it in your stride. This is Cameroon's solution to COVID-19 and beyond. Professor Nalovalyonga, Minister of Secondary Education.
You are welcome to this new teaching session. I am Eke Chokoyo Boris Brice, and a teacher of analytical chemistry. So we will be treating analytical chemistry for the Form 6 class. And we'll continue with the topic that we have started a couple of time ago, gravimetric titrations. And yet, we'll start today with a new lesson, gravimetric analysis, part 4. We have seen gravimetric analysis, part 1, 2, 3, and 3. And today, we are going to see part 4. And what is the fourth part of this lesson? It is the applications of indirect gravimetry titration. Learning competencies. The prerequisites, the learning activities, the summary of the learning activities, the application exercise, as well as the assignment will make up the content of the lesson. Learning competencies. By the end of this lesson, my dear learners, you are supposed to be able to apply the methods of indirect gravimetric titration in chemical analysis. Apply the methods of indirect gravimetric titration in chemical analysis. And as prerequisite, you are supposed to have a good mastery of, number one, the gravimetric factor, which we have seen, the principle of indirect titration that you have seen that in the previous class. You saw it in Form 5. You should be able to apply the principle of indirect titration. Learning activities. My dear learners, for what concerns the indirect titration, the indirect gravimetric titration, which we saw in one of our previous lessons, we said that indirect gravimetric titration is generally used when you have a mixture having two substances that cannot be separated easily. These substances now can be separated using indirect methods, whereby you can either transform them into another few compounds and you carry for weighing, or the two substances will have a common element or a common ion. And when that is done, it therefore means you can proceed with indirect gravimetric titration. What is therefore the principle? The principle is simple. You have a mixture having a mass Z. The mixture contains two substances of mass X and Y. At the end, you can therefore see that the mass of the mixture is equal to the sum of the masses of a constituent. We will now apply the indirect gravimetric titration on each of them. We want to determine the mass of the mixture. What is the mass of the mixture? Yeah, remember we said that we convert them into, we convert the substance into other substances that can be measured. These are the substances that can be measured. We have measured and we have obtained their masses. We will now use these masses and determine the mass of the mixture Z. We will have something like this. The gravimetric, the mass of Z that produces X is equal to the mass of X times the gravimetric factor of X of Z in X. Times the gravimetric factor of Z in X. And we call this mass X, capital letter X. So we have X times the gravimetric factor of Z in X. That's equation one. When we do the same thing for the second substance, we have the mass of Z in Y equals to the mass of Y times the gravimetric factor of Z in Y. We said that this is known as Y. It gives Y times the gravimetric factor of Z in Y. When these two are obtained, you can now know that the mass of that your sample is equal to the sum of these two masses, the mass coming from X and the mass coming from Y. So M of the sample is equal to mass of Z from X plus the mass of Z from Y. That is X plus Y, as we established. So this is the principle of indirect titration. We have now the first example here, whereby they say 2.00 gram. Please, this, my dear student, read with me as I'm reading. Just read alongside with me so that you understand better. 2.00 gram of a commercial fertilizer sample contains 0.8761 gram of a mixture of ammonium sulfate. This is the formula. And potassium sulfate. This sample is treated with barium chloride and 1.502 gram of barium sulfate precipitate is obtained. First question, determine the mass of sulfate present in the precipitate. Secondly, express the mass of sulfate present in the magnesium sulfate and in the ore, in potassium sulfate. I said, determine the mass of sulfate present in the precipitate. That's the first question. Determine, express the mass of sulfate present in magnesium sulfate and the mass of the ore in potassium sulfate. And after that, the next question is, determine the masses of ammonium sulfate and potassium sulfate present in the fertilizer sample. Hence, determine the percentages of ammonium sulfate and of potassium sulfate in the fertilizer sample. My dear learners, we are now going to answer these questions one after the other, applying the principle of indirect gravimetric titration. The first question is, let's come back to the first question, to the example, and we write down our data. I will interpret the example together. They said they mass 2.000 grams of a commercial fertilizer sample. So we have the mass of sample is equal to 2.000. What does it do? It contains 0.8760 grams of a mixture of ammonium sulfate and potassium sulfate. It means the mass of ammonium sulfate plus the mass of potassium sulfate is equal to 0.8761 gram. That's how we interpret. You see, now this sample is treated with barium chloride and 1.502 gram of barium sulfate precipitate is obtained. Mass of the precipitate barium sulfate. What is the mass of the sulfate? 1.502 gram. We now have our data written. Let's now interpret the question one after the other. Determine the mass of sulfate present in the precipitate. Where is the precipitate? This is the precipitate here. What is the mass of sulfate present in the precipitate? Of course, we saw that when we have something like this, it's very simple. We apply our, since we know the mass of the precipitate and they are asking us to determine the mass of the ion, we apply now our relation. That is, mass of sulfate ion in the precipitate is equal to the mass of the precipitate times the gravimetric factor of the sulfate ion in the precipitate. When we have that, it is done. What is the mass of the precipitate? 1.502 gram times. What is the gravimetric factor? The gravimetric factor here, we have in barium sulfate, we have only one molecule of the sulfate ion. So it is one. And we have one molecule of barium sulfate divided by one times the molar mass of the sulfate. What is the molar mass of the sulfate? The molar mass of sulfate is 98.2. When you calculate the molar mass of the sulfate, you are going to have 96.00. Now, just as a recall, I'm not supposed, I believe you already know this. To determine the molar mass, you take this, the molar mass of the atomic mass of sulfur plus 4 times the atomic mass of oxygen. When you do that, you are going to have 96.00. And when you do the same thing for barium sulfate, you are going to have a molar mass of 233.33. And my dear students, when you perform this operation, you are going to have a mass of sulfate ion in the precipitate to be 0.6180 gram. So that is the mass of the sulfate ion present in the precipitate. What is the mass of sulfate ion present? The second question is, express now the mass of sulfate present in ammonium sulfate and in the potassium sulfate. To express that, we need to apply the same principle. We'll consider X to be the mass of ammonium sulfate and Y the mass of potassium sulfate. The mass now of the sulfate in potassium sulfate is equal to the gravimetric factor of the surface in potassium sulfate times the mass of potassium sulfate. Since we do not know the mass of the potassium sulfate, we'll call it Y. That is why the mass now of the sulfate in the potassium sulfate is 0.5505 Y. We'll call that equation 1. Then we do the same thing for sulfate present in ammonium sulfate. In ammonium sulfate, the mass of sulfate present is the gravimetric factor of the sulfate in ammonium sulfate times the mass of the ammonium sulfate. Do we know the mass of the ammonium sulfate? No, but we call it X. It therefore means the mass of the sulfate in ammonium sulfate is the, when we perform the gravimetric factor, we calculate it, we have 0.7272X. We call that equation 2. And so we have now expressed both of them in terms of X and Y. The third question is, they are asking us to determine, let's read the third question and understand better. The third question, determine the masses of ammonium sulfate and potassium sulfate. That means you should determine X and Y. And it's very obvious, it's trivial. Since we have already had this equation, this is the equation that we obtained because we know that the mass of the sulfate in the potassium nitrate plus the mass of the sulfate in the ammonium sulfate will give us the mass of sulfate in the sample. And this is the mass of sulfate in the sample that we have calculated. And that will give us this equation, this new equation with two unknowns. And we know equally that since the mixture is made up of potassium sulfate and nitrate and ammonium sulfate, the mass of the mixture is equal to the mass of potassium sulfate plus the mass of the ammonium sulfate. We call the mass of potassium sulfate X and the mass of ammonium sulfate Y. It therefore means X plus Y will give us the mass of the mixture. That's equation 2. Another equation. We will now bring these two equations together. We'll obtain this simultaneous equation. And my dear students, when you apply your mathematical skills in solving simultaneous equation, you are going to have the value of X to be 0.7684 grams and the value of Y to be 0.1075 grams. Those are their masses in the earth. If you know now there are various masses, can you calculate their various percentages in the fertilizer sample? Yes, by doing the individual masses divided by the mass of the sample, and that will give you the percentage of ammonium sulfate to be 87.73% in the fertilizer. And when you do the same thing with potassium sulfate, you have a 12.27% of potassium sulfate present in the fertilizer. Example 2, we have here, they said, consider 0.4015 grams of a mixture of magnesium chloride and sodium chloride. We have also a mixture. In this case, they have given us the mass of the mixture. It is magnesium chloride and sodium chloride. Mass of magnesium chloride plus mass of sodium chloride is equal to the mass of the mixture, which is 0.4105 grams. After adding an excess of silver nitrate, we obtain 1.032 grams of silver chloride as the precipitate. Mass of the precipitate is equal to 1.032 grams. And the first question is, determine the masses of the two constituents of the mixture, that is magnesium chloride and sodium chloride, that are present in the initial mixture. It is the same principle, my dear students. We'll first of all consider X to be, we'll consider the mass of magnesium chloride to be X, and the mass of sodium chloride to be Y. And it is the combination of these two, the sum of these two masses, that will give us the mass of the sample. And here, we know that the mass of solution, as I was saying, is X plus Y. And it will give us the total mass which is given. This is the mass here, the mass of the sample given. From here, we are now going to determine we are going to express the mass of each of the common element in both species. That is the mass of chlorine in magnesium chloride and the mass of chlorine in sodium chloride. Of course, we know the relation that we are going to apply. The mass of chlorine in magnesium chloride is equal to the mass of magnesium chloride times the gravimetric factor of chlorine in magnesium chloride. And when we are going to calculate, remember, A here will be 2 because we have 2 atoms of chlorine in magnesium chloride. So the gravimetric factor will be, here we consider it as X times 2/1 molar mass of chlorine divided by molar mass of magnesium chloride. You obtain, when you perform that, you are going to obtain the first relation, which is 0.7794x. And we'll do the same thing with the second sample. And we'll obtain a relation of 0.4697Y as a mass of chlorine in sodium chloride. When we now have these two, we know that the mass of chlorine present in the precipitate is equal to the gravimetric factor of chlorine in the precipitate times the mass of the precipitate. Of course, because the precipitate is the final product, it also contains the same element. And when we perform that, since we know the mass of the precipitate, we'll have a fixed value of 0.2548. And my dear students, since we know that the precipitate is the final compound product, and the precipitate is obtained from magnesium chloride and sodium chloride, it therefore means that the mass of the chlorine found in the precipitate is the sum of the masses of chlorine found in the two substances. And when you add the masses, you obtain this equation. When you take the mass of chlorine found in magnesium chloride that we calculated, plus the mass of chlorine found in sodium chloride, which we calculated, it will give us the mass of the chlorine found in the precipitate. We obtain this equation. And we know our main equation, which is X plus Y equals to 0.4015, corresponds to the mass of the mixture. My dear students, resolving the simultaneous equation obtained will give you a mass of the magnesium chloride. Will have a mass of 0.2139 grams, and the sodium chloride will have a mass of 0.1876. And quickly, let's look at this application exercise, whereby we still have 2.00 grams of the sample made of only lithium chloride and potassium chloride are converted to a mixture of lithium sulfate and potassium sulfate of mass 3.000 grams. The first question is, calculate the masses of lithium chloride and potassium chloride present in the initial sample. Always the same question. You can see that it is always the same question. You apply the principle. Second question, calculate the masses of lithium sulfate and potassium sulfate present in the precipitate. My dear students, we are still going to proceed in the same light. We will consider the mass of the mixture, which is the mass of lithium chloride and potassium chloride, to be Z. And individual masses, we will consider them to be X and Y. And we know that it is the sum of these masses that gives Z. Therefore, we have our first equation, X plus Y, will give us the mass of the sample, which is 2.000. We'll now use our gravimetric factor expression to the indirect gravimetric analysis to determine to write the masses of lithium present in both samples. Now the mass of lithium sulfate will be equal to the gravimetric factor of lithium in lithium chloride times the mass of lithium chloride. And when you perform this, you are going to have a mass written in function of X. And what do we say X is? We said that X is the mass of lithium chloride. And we have 1.2945X as the mass of lithium sulfate. We do the same thing with the mass of potassium sulfate. The mass of potassium sulfate will be the gravimetric factor times the mass of potassium chloride. And we know that the mass of potassium chloride is X. And the gravimetric factor will give us 1.1689. Thus, the mass of sulfate is equal to the mass of sulfate obtained from lithium sulfate plus the mass of sulfate obtained from potassium sulfate. Bringing this equation together will form us the second equation with two unknown. And my dear students, you now have another simultaneous equation. When you have this simultaneous equation, the resolution of it will give you the mass of lithium chloride to be 0.5255 grams, and the mass of potassium chloride is 1.4745 grams. Those are the masses, and that is how we calculate. The second question is, calculate the masses of sulfate. Of course, if we want to determine the masses of sulfate, what do? We just simply take the mass of the lithium sulfate is equals, when they talk of the mass of the sulfate, it means what are the sulfate that we have? We have lithium sulfate and we have potassium sulfate. So they are telling us to calculate the mass of lithium sulfate and the mass of potassium sulfate. What do we say is the mass of lithium sulfate? Remember the expression that we had up here. We said that the mass of lithium sulfate, let me show you clearly. We said that the mass of lithium sulfate is equal to 1.2945X, and the mass of potassium sulfate is 1.1689X. When we now, resolving the simultaneous equation gave us the answer of X and Y. When we fit it in both equations, we obtain the masses of both sulfates. The mass of the lithium sulfate is 0.6384 grams on one hand, and the mass of potassium sulfate is 2.3615 grams on the other hand. My dear students, we have come to the end of this lesson. In our next class, we'll start a new topic, which is qualitative study of complexes. Unatege si matege yob, unatege minga matege nyom, unatege majang matege ndom, manetambia ninyane njubyayan, ngani bana matege mot, ngani lakiri watege ndong, esekina bia dinkido, manetambia ninyane njubyayan, tamtama mote tamzabike, Tam tam atonge tam zabike tam 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 amote tam zabike mane tambia ninyane njubyayan